Today, I'm going to teach you how to meet a stranger. This is advice from FBI counterintelligence officer Joe Navarro, one of the leading experts on body language and reading body language. It comes from his book, What Everybody is Saying, an ex-FBI's agent's guide to speed reading people. My name is Kirk Double K Barbera, and this is your Business Book Tip of the Day. Okay, so I'm gonna read this tip today, and this is a very helpful thing if you're in sales or business, or really just in life if you're meeting people on a regular basis in a networking event or something. There are definitely ways of meeting people that are better than others. And just to give you a quick little example, I guess, of the power of body language, just picture in your mind or walk to a networking event and watch people for a little bit before you talk to them. Just go to the event while it's already busy, or maybe when it's just getting started, whatever, but just look around before you talk to anybody. And watch when some people enter a room, for instance, and the energy levels. And you can tell, you know, people walking in like this, you know, heads down, they bring the energy way down. But someone's like, hey, what's up? Like, and then all of a sudden, the room gets all pumped up. That's what's up, you know, high fives, that brings energy, and it's through body language. And so reading body language is the same kind of concept. It's you're looking at the way people move in the world, you know, how they react to certain things. If you say something and they're going like this, they're blocking their eyes, that means they don't like what they're seeing. If you're talking to someone and they're going like this all the time, this is a very automatic reptilian response of being uncomfortable. Okay, so I'm gonna read this note card of what to do with your arms when you meet a stranger. So in other words, how to meet a stranger. When approaching a stranger for the first time, try demonstrating warmth by leaving your arms relaxed, like this. Preferably with the ventral side, so this is your ventral side, the vent side, exposed, and perhaps even with the palms of your hands clearly visible. This is a very powerful way of sending the message, hello, I mean no harm, to the other person's limbic system. It's a great way of putting the other person at ease and facilitating any interaction that follows. So, in other words, it's not a good idea to have, when you're meeting someone, to have your hands in your pocket, especially if you're a guy and you're meeting a girl. It's actually not a good thing to do at first, right? And a lot of this is what's called the limbic responses. So a person consciously may not have a problem. They may not think about the problem, but on a subconscious level, the hands in the pocket can be a very scary thing, especially for a woman, because they don't know what's going on, right? Like on a subconscious, fundamental animal instinct way. So one of the ways, just when you're meeting someone for the first couple seconds, a very good way to meet them is just, you know, hands out, just, hey, how, you know, this expresses very simply a comfortable, relaxed, calm, warm way of saying, hey, how you doing? It's nice to meet you. And then of course the handshake. But that's an important part of it, is let them see, let their limbic brain feel that you mean no harm. And that's it, that's how to meet a stranger. And make them comfortable from the beginning, and it makes everything else good from then on out. Okay, my name is Kirk Double K Barbera. This is your Business Book Tip of the Day. Remember, reading is not a passive sport, it's a contact sport. So go out there and make some contact with people. With books, not with people. Well, people too, that's fine.